Scott Mullen, Executive Director at the Taxslayer Center. And so this event was the last event we had set up for before the pandemic hit. And it's appropriately the first event we get to reopen with. Unfortunately, there's no tickets for sale to the general public, but we do have 50 people per game, so the parents of the players are here. But it's exciting to get the events going again. And this just tips off the season for us, and we'll come back with, once we get some more information from the state and the governor's office, what capacity we can open at. We can start plugging some events in, and then we have events that are holding patterns right now, waiting to see what happens and when. But Frankie Valley is scheduled for June. That could move if we don't get word soon. But then as we get into the summer, we have One Night at Queen. That was a really successful show that we had here a couple of years ago, and they wanted to come back, and that's July 23rd, and then in August we have Matchbox 20 and the Wallflowers, and then Michael Bublé in September, and Kane Brown after that, and all the shows, those are shows that were scheduled before that are not new tours. Then the new tours will start falling in after that. We've got a couple of Christian acts coming, we've got a couple of country, like I said, we've got a big rock act that wants to play at the end of the year. That hasn't been announced yet, and then our Disney on Ice. The Quad City Storm is planning on doing their full season next year, and they're really excited about that. They've been planning this whole time to make sure they come back better than ever. The first home game is supposed to be the last weekend in October right now. After that, hopefully, we're just back to normal. But this is the start of it, and we're really excited that we're finally doing events again.
Okay, and you do have a lot of events that are scheduled that you're hoping will go, but if it doesn't look like the pandemic stuff is ready yet, they'll reschedule. Is that correct?
Yeah, but another big one was JoJo Siwo's this summer. She's kind of, they're waiting, they're holding dates in December, and other backup dates after that, because tours takes, the logistics of a 70-city tour takes a long time to get put together. So we keep, when the governor says, okay, you can open, we can't just open. They just can't roll out a brand new tour. They have to have it all planned out, so it takes time. You have to get things on sale. It takes at least 6 weeks to sell the show, typically. So, once it starts, there are acts out there that I can bring in here and there. They're playing a fair or a festival or an amphitheater in the region, and I can get them to stop by here. So I expect we'll have some events at reduced capacity before we get back to full capacity towards the end of the summer.
Okay, and what are some of the other safety measures you're going to have in place in the time being? So this one has very limited capacity as far as just limited to family members and stuff like that, correct? So the stands aren't going to be full of people for these games.
Right.
What are some of the other measures that you have in place right now as far as COVID-19 protocols?
We spent the entire last year preparing to reopen safely. We went out and got a Global Biorisk Advisory Council accreditation, which is it was a 100-page document we had to put together and submit that documents your training, make sure you're using chemicals that are effective against SARS virus, making sure that you're doing employee training and follow through. We've put Wi-Fi in the arena. We have mobile ordering now from your phone to receipt, so you don't have to wait in a concession line with other people. You just order it, you get a notification when it's ready, and then you just walk up and pick it up from the stand. We put in touchless flush valves and sinks, so to eliminate touch points throughout the building. We've got UV lights on the escalator handrails that sanitize the handrail as it goes around automatically. We've got teams of people that electrostatic spray the entire building constantly. They're wiping down around, they're going up and down the aisles during the event, wiping railings. We've done so many things with training just to make sure that it's safe. And we have cashless concessions now, so cash isn't changing hands. So those are the types of things that we're doing to keep it safe. So it's a heck of a lot safer than almost any building in the area right now. It's safer than going to the grocery store. It's safer than going home anywhere outside your home. So we want people to know that when they come back here that it's going to be safe to do so.
All right, thank you.